Hi, I'm going to show you how PowerNull works. PowerNull is a pretty quick and easy tool for creating a whole ton of nulls very quickly, very accurately. I'll go through all the features one at a time and show you how to get up and running. When you install PowerNull, you can find it in the script UI panels down in here, or you can even run it as a script or a keyboard shortcut, but I'll show you a bit of that later. When you open PowerNull, this is what the panel looks like. Just a very small two-button panel. This button right here, the null, is what does all the work. So, basics. To get started with PowerNull, you just click the null icon and you click. Click right in the composition. And you can see as I'm clicking, nulls are being added exactly where I clicked. You can also click and drag to position them exactly where you need. That's all it takes. And when you're done with PowerNull, you just switch tools, for example. Or you could also deselect the interface layer. And it'll turn everything back to normal, turn your tools back to normal. You're ready to go. And another quick little feature is, if you want to add a null to the center of the comp, dead center, just run it again. Simple. Alright, let's show you snapping. PowerNull lets you snap to layers just by following the instructions here. Hold Alt or Option to snap. So as you click and drag, hold Alt, and you can see that you can snap to corners. Just like that. You can even snap to edges. As you hover the mouse over an edge or a vertex or a corner or an anchor point even, it'll snap. Next up is parenting. Like any good null tool, you need to be able to parent layers to a null. So you select your layers and run PowerNull. You can see a little box is drawn around all the layers you selected, so you can see the bounding box. Then, let's follow the little instructions, then add a null here. And instantly, a null will be made. Everything is all parented. Let's do that again and snap to the center. There we go, right about there. There we go, perfect. And it also respects existing hierarchies, so this null right here is now parented to the original null. Alright. Parenting and snapping. This one's pretty straightforward. So when you parent layers, you can also snap the null to any corner or anchor or anything. So if you ever need to add a null to the corner or an edge of a layer, just hold Alt and it'll snap right there. Perfect. Let's do this one here and snap a null to the center, to the anchor point. There you go. Easy. PowerNull also supports snapping in 3D. So you got all these layers, all these shape layers that are in different depths and everything like that. So when you run PowerNull, it quickly calculates all the edges of everything. And you can see when I let go and add a null, it positions it in the correct 3D space. This also works if you select a couple of different layers. So let's go with these ones right here. Run PowerNull, and you've got a nice bounding box showing you exactly what you've selected. You can add a null to the... can add a null to, let's say, this one back here. Look at that. Perfect. Another very useful feature for any good null tool is linking properties to nulls. So let's say we got this advanced lightning right here. We want to link this origin to a null. Just select the origin or go in the timeline and select it here. And then run instant null. Click exactly where you want the null, right there. And look at that. Just like that, there's an expression linking it together. Let me show you something else you could do with that. We got this grid right here, and a beam right here. I'm just going to add keyframes so it can easily find the properties. You can link multiple properties to the same null. Just click right here. Look at that. Another nice feature is, it's not just position properties that you can link. You can link all sorts of properties. So let's say we got the grid anchor, we got border, we got the color, and we got the fractal noise, evolution, and offset turbulence. I'm just going to click a bunch of stuff. And rotation, that's a good one. So we got all these properties right here. Just select them however you want to do it, whether it's keyframes or however. Add a null right here will do. And there you go. You can see that everything is linked to the null. The color is also linked to a slider, which is by default red, so you got to change that up a little bit. And the border is also linked to the slider as well. So any single values will be added to a will be added to a slider control. Colors will be linked to a color control. position will be linked to the null itself, and the rotation will also be linked to the null's rotation. All right, one more thing with linked properties. Let's say you've got a couple of properties. Let's just add these things to a null. All linked to the same thing, great. But now, oh no, we've added another effect, a beautiful lens flare that we want to parent to that null as well. What you do is you select the property and you select an existing null. And when you run this twice, boom, you will see it corrects it and links it all to the same null. Finally, let's get into the settings for Power Null. If you have the script panel open, you access it by clicking the hamburger menu button right here. If you have the script open by keyboard shortcut or something, you just run the script, twirl down the settings, or twirl down the properties and click settings. In either case, it's going to open up this settings window. So let's go through the settings real quick. Let's start with center anchor points. Let me show you what that does. It's pretty obvious, but turn that off, hit save settings, run the script and add a couple of nulls. You'll see that the nulls by default have the anchors in the corner, in the top left corner. Center the anchor points, hit save settings and run it. As you're adding it, it adds the nulls based on the anchor point in the center. And you can see the anchor points are officially in the center. Pretty obvious, that one. Link properties confirmation. I'll show you what problem it solves. Let's go with that. So we've got this power layer right here. Click it, run the script and add a null right over here. And it works. The layer is parented. Fantastic. However, if you move this layer, run the script, click, and all right. Oh, wait, why did the layer snap? Oh, it's parented. But the layer's not parented. What's going on? Well, it added an expression to the position property. When you move a layer in After Effects, it selects the position property. Oops, wrong section. Ah, it selects the position property. Well, it's not doing it right now, of course. There you go. So that means when you run power null, it's going to assume you meant to link that. That's not a wanted thing. So link properties confirmation, turn that on. Let's move this, run the script. And when you run power null, it'll say, hey, you have property selected. Are you sure about this? You click yes to link properties, no dependent layers. If you click yes, it will link the properties, you know, by expression. If you hit no, it'll basically assume you meant to select the layer. So you hit no, and the layer will be parented as normal. Now, invert dragging. So there is a glitch on Max, I believe. Yeah, you want to add a null, you want to click and drag. Okay, look, he's clicking and dragging correctly. Fantastic. However, invert dragging, let me show you what happens. It will do this. You click and drag. Oh, the null's heading off in the opposite direction. That is not right. Again, it's a Mac and Windows thing. When you first run Power Null, it's going to automatically set that for you. It's just going to check if you're using Mac or Windows and set that option for you. But if you're using this tool and it happens to be wrong, just toggle that manually. Next one, null name. All right, so by default, Power Null ## is on. What that will do is when you add a null, it'll call it power null 965, 967, 969, some huge numbers. But you can change this. You can change it to decide per null, which as you add the nulls, let me just get that up. Name of null, null 1, null 2. You can see the names are being corrected right here. Third and final setting there is custom. You can write your own custom naming format. And earlier in this settings thing, I've been using this ##. So in short, we have new null layer. New null layer. So new null layer 1# is going to count up all the power nulls that you've created so far and say 2. That's the second power null. 3, 4, 5. However, 2#, say ##, just like up in here, gives you the layer ID. So every single layer in After Effects has a unique ID. No matter if you've duplicated a layer or what, it's a unique ID, which means there won't be any risk of expressions overlapping. That is all the settings. Oh, and the last one is if you... So, save settings obviously saves whatever you set. The help will give you the official AE scripts and AE plugins help menu, which looks like this. It gives you a quick overview of all the things and a little button to go back to the PowerNL page on AE scripts and a link to the YouTube tutorial. If you have other scripts from AE scripts, you might be familiar with this. I mentioned before that you can run this as a keyboard shortcut. Here's how it's done. PowerNL works as a script on its own. It doesn't need to be docked. So when you add the script to the script UI folder, just add it also to the scripts folder. That looks like this. You got the scripts folder where I've got all my lovely little scripts and I've got sitting right here. When you run it as a script, it instantly opens up and lets you start adding nulls everywhere. And that's how you run it as a keyboard shortcut. You go into keyboard shortcuts, you type in power null, and it'll be sitting in your scripts folder somewhere down here. And that's it for PowerNull. That is really all there is to it. It is designed to feel like a missing tool in the toolbar. So just imagine there's a little null icon up here and it works just like that. Works live, works very, 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 very fast. Two last things before I forget. First off, you'll know you're in null mode when you can see a little icon up here. If you need to add a null to that corner, it'll just go vanishing a little bit so you get close to it. And finally, after you make a null, if you want to hit undo, it takes a few little undos. 1, 2, 3, 4. You just need to hit undo 2 or 4 times, depending how you made a null. Well, that's really it. Take care.